Welcome back to Bazooka Kickboxing and MMA. Today's episode, powered by Hayabusa, is all about changing your power and intensity in your punches mid-combination. In today's episode, we're talking about changing the power and the intensity of your punches mid-combination. And the first thing I see when I see someone throw only power shots is inexperience. And when you first learn striking, everything is basically on pads, and it's all about power and intensity. But a lot of times, we take that all the way even into the professional levels of fighting. But the true understanding of striking is understanding the power and the intensity, and that not every strike is the same. Little changes make a big difference, whether it's the angle, right? Whether it's the timing, whether it's the way you throw it, the way you breathe, the way you lift your head off. Small changes make a big difference. But one of the biggest differences you could make is changing the power of the strike. And even more advanced, doing it mid-combination, all right? So let's take it back to tell me and to tell you what the biggest difference is, and I'll show you how to do it. So now let's talk about the jab. Now, the jab to a beginner is just a jab. You step, you throw, but really the jab, outside of throwing it vertical, horizontal, maybe on a different angle, just how hard I throw it and at what distance. So I might throw the jab as a probing jab, right? Boom, right? I'm not even touching my opponent. I'm occupying space, but it's still a jab. And it's doing something. It's keeping my opponent away from me. It's making my opponent second guess by just keeping this pawing punch out, right? So that's a low intensity shot, not a lot of power, right? Now, sometimes I might throw a snapping jab to the guard just to get a reaction, right? I'm still not hitting my opponent, but this time I'm throwing it faster, right? But with less power. So my first punch was light and pawing. The second one was fast and snapping. And then all of a sudden I got a reaction. All of a sudden, boom, I throw a hard spearing jab, right? So there's one example with the jab, which is one of our most effective weapons to set things up. You can throw it with three different types of power and three different types of distance and intensity, right? And this is what the video is about. Understanding that you don't have to throw everything the same way in a power combination. So let's start talking about the concepts of combination. Now, even with the jab, right? And I throw a double jab. A combination is basically single strikes put together, right? To make a combo. So even in one hand, the jab, I can throw a setup to a probing jab, right? Occupy to a spear, right? Ding, boom. So even within the two punches, I'm changing the power and changing the intensity. So this is when now when you watch fights, this is when you start picking up on who the elite strikers are, right? Watch some of the elite. Watch Israel Adesanya fight a wrestler, right? He's gonna occupy space. He's gonna throw snapping long punches. But when he has you hurt and he's committed, he's gonna snap, turn the punch over and give you the power, right? So this is where you start seeing the intensity differences. Now, even when you're talking about MMA, let's talk about the rear hand. If I overthrow this rear hand with power all the time in a single way, it's easy for me to be taken down. It's easy for my opponent to counter, maybe to slip and rip. So sometimes I might just throw a nice snapping punch, snap, snap, take an angle, boom, and then change it and get the power. So light, 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 power, right? So light, 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 step in. Light, 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 power uppercut, right? So even within the mid combination, the changing of the power, the changing of the intensity is gonna mess my opponent up. Think about you defensively. Say you're in a fight or even sparring and someone's just throwing light punches. One, two, right? I'm catching. One, two. Then all of a sudden they step in. One, two, boom. I'm not expecting it. I was expecting a light snapping punch, a probing punch. Then all of a sudden, mid-combination, I didn't see it. They stepped in, they closed the distance, they put the power in, and that's when you get the damage, okay? So watch how people use it. Now, one of the more easier ways to use this and what you'll see a lot is to set up the body shot. So lighter shots, right, help the guard move. So I might throw light punches upstairs to get my opponent's hands to rise, and then all of a sudden, boom, boom, bang. Right? That's when I start ripping in the power shots to the body, right? So even again, mid-combination, I'm using lighter setup punches to get the finish to the body, right? So this is where experience, this is where the poetry of the striking comes along. So now if you look at my type of combinations, I'm known for my kicks, right? And again, being a kickboxing and MMA channel, using setup versus power punches is gonna help you determine how you use your kicks. because I'm a kicker, I use a lot of those nice guard style punches, right? If I overthrow my punches, right, it might be harder for me to really set up my kicks. So when you see me punch a lot of times and you know I'm gonna kick really hard, you'll see me use more of the probing style punches so I can get a reaction, create a distraction now, right? By me throwing these light probing punches upstairs, it's just gonna get my opponent to think I'm only boxing. They raise their hands, I can chop the body or really dig hard to the liver, right? I'm using light punches to manipulate the guard, to hit the body, to continue to attack the legs. And I'm still gonna follow the principle of light, light, power, right? Light, light, boom, step in and get power. So when you put all of that together and you mix it in mid-combination, this is where you start really seeing high, high level striking now. No better way to see this than with boxers, right? Even if when you're touching the head, touch, touch, to go hard rip to the body, one of my favorite combinations, light, light, light to the head, and then boom, you rip to the body, right? So the way you use the punches with power and intensity make a big difference, okay? So take your time sometimes, film yourself when you're doing your power stuff and just see how you can add it. Now, a simple way if you're a beginner to implement this concept, right, is just throwing maybe a 3-4 punch combination. Start with something very simple, jab, cross, hook, kick. Now, with this principle, all you have to do is change one of the strikes to a power strike. So I can go right here, light, power, light, power, right? So I'm changing it mid combination, light, light, power, power, right? So even within one combination, two of the four were light, the last two were powerful. I can do light, 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 power, right? It doesn't matter, but no matter what, even if you're sparring me, I can continually change which one is the power shot and you're never gonna know. It's gonna make you flinch harder, make you bite on my feints a little bit more. So really, I'm able to land a little bit more and I have you thinking, right? So quick recap to end this video. Just remember, changing the intensity of your punches is what's really gonna show if you're a beginner, intermediate, or advanced. So adding these little touches, the light light to set up the big power, just shows how advanced you are. And it's just gonna show how much you can develop as a martial artist. And watch now, understanding this concept, understanding occupying the space versus touching the guard versus stepping in power. The master of stand-up striking is the master of distance and range, and the master of deciding when and how they're gonna implement those power shots, okay? So think about that as your concept for the week. All right, hope you like today's episode. Keep liking, subscribing, and sharing Bazooka Kickboxing and MMA. Support HayabusaFight.com, the T3 boxing gloves, my personal favorite. Hayabusa, make sure their shin guards and all of their gear as well, the shorts as well, very comfortable as their new line is coming out. And Perfect Sports Nutrition, if you need your supplements, use the code Bazooka20, link in the description below. BazookaShop.com for all the gear, and the tank tops have been a great seller. And last but not least, bazookatraining.com for only $9.99 a month. I give you weekly videos, four of them. You get a home workout, a bag workout, tutorial, and sparring drills. Four videos a week for only $9.99 a month. And I just put on Instagram, use this as a way as homework, right? Study from your class, study the training, study all the videos, but do your practice and your bag work at home so you can supplement your training, right? $9.99 a month. BazookaTraining.com. All right, we'll see you next time at Bazooka Training and here as well on YouTube at Bazooka Kickboxing and MMA.
Over 1 year in lockdown, an empty gym, a divided community. Many questions unanswered.
They're doing the best they can, trying to save their business.
But on one man's 36th birthday, he decided to fight back. Subscribe now for only $9.99 USD a month. BazookaTraining.com.